There are some very important rules that we have to follow when we name or come up with the formulae of substances. An important rule is, for example, if we take something like carbon and oxygen and we add them together, then we need to know which one will go first in our name. So the rule says that the element that is on the left-hand side of the periodic table will usually be written first when naming the compound. Now, I've specifically chosen carbon and oxygen because they are both non-metals, but if you look at your periodic table, you'll see carbon is a little bit more to the left than oxygen. So if we have one carbon and one oxygen, it's going to form something called carbon monoxide, where mono, or MON, tells us that we only have one oxygen. If we had one carbon and two oxygens, it would have been carbon dioxide. So here we see di indicating the amount of oxygens that will bond to the carbon. Notice also that when we add two elements that make up this formula, the name will end in IDE. Very important. Let's just look at another example. If we take sodium and chlorine and we add them together, if you look at your periodic table, you'll notice that sodium is a metal and chlorine a non-metal. So according to our rules, sodium must go first in the name and chlorine second in the name. So when we come up with this name, if we have one sodium and one chlorine, it's going to be sodium chloride, ending with IDE because we are adding two elements together. Now, sometimes a compound may also contain ions. So an example of an ion here would be sulfate, SO4 2-. If I had sulfuric acid, H2SO4, the sulfuric acid name is the common name for this specific or everyday name for this specific formula. Let's look at the name here. This would have been dihydrogen sulfate. Why sulfate? Because SO4 2- is an ion. And you will remember that I said that an ion consists of either an element or a couple of elements bond together that now has a charge. Here we see that sulfate has this 2- charge. So when we learn chemistry, one of the most important things is that we need to remember that it's like learning a new language. There are certain things that we have to memorize. So there are common ions that we need to know in grade 10, going forward all the way through grade 12. The first one is ammonium, NH4+. Ammonium. The second one is carbonate, CO3 2-. Then we have sulfate, SO4 2-, that we've already had a look at. We have sulfite, SO3 2-. Then we also have nitrate, NO3-, nitrate. We have nitrite, which is NO2-. Then we have phosphate, a very important one, PO4 3-, phosphate. Another one that's very important, permanganate. Have a look at this, it's MnO4-, permanganate. And then just two more, ClO3- is called chlorate, and ClO2- is called chlorite. Now, these names of these common ions you will have to memorize. Very important here that you notice that when we have a certain amount of oxygens, the maximum amount, in fact, the name ends in ADE. If we have one less oxygen, the name ends in ITE. Let's have a look at this quickly. Sulfate, 4 oxygens. Sulfite, 3 oxygens combined to sulfur. If you look at nitrate, it has the maximum amount of oxygens. Nitrite has one less. Same goes for chlorate. It has 3 oxygens while chloride only has 2. So remember that when you have one less, normally the name will end with I-T-E. Now, when we also look at the everyday names, there are some very important ones that we need to focus on. These everyday names of formulae and compounds include things like water. When we talk about water, you know that we're talking about H2O. If we were to go and give this a chemical name, it would have been dihydrogen oxide. But we don't talk about dihydrogen oxide. We use the everyday name water. Then another common one, HCl, swimming pool acid, is also known as hydrochloric acid. The real name here for the chemical substance is hydrogen chloride, but we hardly ever talk about hydrogen chloride. Then a common one that you might know from home, ethanoic acid, also known as vinegar. And this is the chemical formula, CH3COOH. Now, don't go home tonight and go and say, can I have some of the ethanoic acid, please? Vinegar is the everyday name that we use. An example here would be, let's do Na2CO3. Now remember, the 2 indicates, if I had to go and draw this molecule, that I have 2 sodiums attached to my carbonate. Now my carbonate is 1 carbon and then 3 oxygens. So this is actually what sodium carbonate in molecular form will look like. The name sodium carbonate. Would it have been wrong to say disodium carbonate? No. But this is the name that you have to know. Remember, when we pick the name, we go for the most correct option. When we have a diatomic molecule, for example, we have Cl2, it means that we actually have 2 chlorine atoms. This is not just called chlorine, it is called chloride, C-H-L-O-R-I-D-E, chloride, I-D-E. Why I-D-E at the end? Because 2 chlorine atoms have attached to one another, therefore the name chloride.